right now. So one of the coolest things to me about a coincidence is the less control that you have over a situation, the greater the seemingly impossible coincidence you can create. So we're going to take all control away. I'd like you to mix this up. First off, what does that look like to you?
A Rubik's Cube.
It is a Rubik's Cube. Anything weird about it?
There are numbers on it.
There are. Yeah, numbers on it, 1 through 9 on all 6 sides. Also a little unusual that it's solved, but that's why I'm going to have you unsolve it. Go ahead and mix it up as much as you like. And then, Amika, I'm going to have you write your name on one of these. Now, this is not a pack of cards. It's like blank pieces of cardstock, sort of for obsessive magicians to take notes on. So I'll have you write your name. Go ahead and take the marker and write your name just on one side for me, please. And you satisfied that that's pretty well mixed? Yeah, maybe, kind of, sort of, close enough. Great. And let's get rid of this for now. So, Mika, your card. Why don't you hand the Rubik's Cube to Mika, please? And Mika, you take a chance at mixing it as well. And Victoria, Mika's card is going to go back about halfway down. Now, not exactly. It's going to go a little bit less than half. I'm going to have you mix some cards. Now, you can turn some over like that if you want. In fact, you know what? Why don't you just take about half of them, mix them up as much as you like. And you satisfied that that's mixed?
One second.
Okay. You're doing it thoroughly. Yes. Perfect. That's great. That's exactly what we're looking for. So you mixed that pretty well. I'd like you to mix these as well. Just go and give them a good shuffle. All right. So once you're satisfied that those are mixed and these are mixed, and the Rubik's Cube is, of course, mixed as well. You satisfied? You're pretty good? Excellent. Yeah. Do you want to mix them anymore? You're good. Mm-hmm. All right. Let's take these and take these. That's how you mixed them. That's how they're going to stay. This is where it gets kind of strange. Go ahead and give me a color.
Green.
Green. Excellent. Let's find the green side here. There's the green side right there. I'm going to keep the Rubik's Cube against the table for right now, but here's the green side. That is green there. And you can see all the numbers are a little different. You have a 6, a 7, and a 6. Up here, we have 2, a 9, and a 4, right? On the another side, the blue side over here is 8, 9, 2, 2, 9, 6, and so forth. There's one side we can't see, and that's how you put it down. You gave me the Rubik's Cube mixed up. You put it down with one side we can't see. That is the red side. Now, there's 43 quintillion combinations of a Rubik's Cube. That means you could mix it for the rest of your life, all of the lives in the world for the rest of their lives, and you'd still never come up with the same combination. 43 quintillion combinations. Now, what that means is this is never going to happen again. Let's give you a little example. We're going to write this down, these exact numbers. And Victoria, just make sure I'm writing the right numbers down. I'll make a little tic-tac-toe here, mm-hmm. Match this up. And so this top row, that's an 8, a 3, and a 4, correct? Mm-hmm. And what's the second row?
1.
5.
9.
9. And the last bottom row. Mm-hmm.
6. 7. 2.
7. 2. Excellent. And again, if you mix it up further, you'd end up with a different combination of numbers. We'll put this off to the side. Go ahead and take those cards for me. As you mixed them up, you both mixed them up, right?
Mm-hmm.
You both mixed up the Rubik's Cube. Go ahead and take that top card, turn it over for me, please. That's card number 1. All right, turn the next one over and 2, and count them out loud just into a pile until you find Mika's card.
3, mm-hmm. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13,
it's killing me.
14, 15.
About 50, okay, good. It is still there. No one palmed it out. 15 down, right? Now that's how you mixed it up. You mixed up the cards, you mixed up the cards. This is where it gets crazy. These aren't important. But if you look at these numbers, remember, you mixed this up as much as you want. You ended up with that combination. It was, how many down was it?
15?
15. Look at this top row. We have 8 plus 3 is 11. 11 plus 4 is?
15.
Well, look at the second row. This is crazy. 1 plus 5 is 6 plus 9 is 15. You both mixed up that Rubik's Cube. Bottom row, 6 and 7 is 13 plus 2 is 15. This is crazy. You mix it up. 43 quintillion combinations. 8 and 1 is 9 plus 6 is 15. 3 and 5 is 8 plus 7 is 15. 4 and 9 is 13 plus 2. Even the diagonals. This is crazy. But 8 plus 5 is 13 plus 2 is 15. 4 and 5 is 9 plus 6. 15. Remember, 43 quintillion. That is an amazing coincidence that you just created.
What?